aging Pastor Ken. Has anyone seen Pastor Ken? Hey guys. Okay, I guess I got to start this thing off because Pastor Ken is running late yet again. If you're here with us on Sundays, you know how this goes. So anyway, welcome everybody to another episode of Full Turn Kid Zone at Home. Take that, Pastor Ken. One shot. And do y'all remember what we do? The first thing? Hello? Anybody? Oh, that's right. We're on video. My bad. We pray. That's right. So everybody bow your heads, fold your hands, and close your eyes. Yes, got it. All right, here we go. Dear Heavenly Father God, we just thank you for another opportunity to come before your presence and learn more about you. God, I just pray that you would be with every household watching this episode. Just go with them as they go into their week so that they can serve you in every way possible. In your name we pray. Amen. Let's see. I think we've got somebody. Oh,
Amen.
Hey, Vern, what's going on?
Hey, my name is Vern.
I know. I just said your name.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So what's new?
Not much. Have you had a good week?
Oh, I ran out of bird seed.
You did? Well, you
it
know
was
what?
Terrible.
Well, hey, Vern.
What?
I got you covered.
Hey, that's my name.
I got you covered.
I'll see you later.
Okay. Okay, I guess I'm doing announcements now, too. Oh, dear. This is going to be a mess backstage. Oh, boy.
Got any more?
No, that's all I got.
Oh.
Darn.
Hi, my name is Vern.
Yes, I know, Vern. I think you've told everybody that about a bajillion times now.
Oh, a bajillion?
Yeah, no, that's a big number, isn't it?
Is that more than one?
Way more than one.
Oh, my brain's hurting.
It doesn't take much, does it? So what's the first announcement, Vern?
That my name is Vern.
That's not the first announcement.
Is it not?
No, we've already established that your name is Vern.
That
quite
everybody
a few
gives
times.
Me bird seed.
I already gave you bird seed.
You did?
Yes, I did.
Oh. I better go check. I'm right back.
Oh, goodness.
Hold on. Wait. Don't go anywhere.
We're waiting on you. We can't go anywhere until you come back and finish your job.
I forgot.
The first announcement.
Something about... Yeah! That's it!
Yeah.
That's it!
Yeah, tickets. Do you remember the ways that we can earn tickets?
Not a clue.
Of course. I should have seen that coming.
How do you do it?
Well, you're here.
Yeah.
That's one way to earn a ticket.
Yeah. Oh, I get a ticket right now.
Did you bring your Bible?
My name is Vern.
Yes, I know. We all know that your name is Vern.
Bible. Okay, ticket. Bible.
You didn't bring your Bible, did you?
Offering.
But do you have an offering? That's another way to get a ticket.
Do I have to give 10% of my bird seed?
Well, you know, if you're going to tithe, you could give 10% of your bird seed to other birds who might be in need. You know, they might be hungry.
I can cough it up.
Oh, dear. Oh, dear. I'm so sorry that you kids had to witness that. Oh, dear. Vern.
Kind of makes a mess.
Vern, it makes a big mess, Vern.
Yeah.
Are you going to clean that up?
I'll eat it later.
Oh, dear. Yeah, that's an image that I need. How else can we earn tickets, Vern?
Look at the blue color light.
So we have a safe ticket also, kids. I'm just going to keep rolling here since Vern's off in the clouds somewhere.
I like the lights.
Yes, I know. Pretty lights. Pretty lights, aren't they?
Pretty lights.
So, kids,
my name is Vern.
Oh, dear. I don't get paid enough. So, kids, with the safe ticket, when you come in on Sunday, if you get your ticket drawn out of the safe, you win a really big prize. And it's not a big bag of bird seed.
Oh! Well, that's not a prize then.
Yeah, see, I beat you to it there.
Oh.
So, what's our next announcement, Vern? We're taking up too much time here. We got to keep moving.
I know. It has to do with a bird.
No, it doesn't.
Yeah!
No, it doesn't.
Well, who else lays eggs?
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, Vern.
We got Easter coming up.
You're killing me, Vern. Oh, Vern. Yes, we have Easter coming up. And what are we doing for Easter, Vern?
An egg extravaganza.
That's right. We are having an Easter egg extravaganza.
Yep.
Do you have any details on that?
Oh, I better go start laying eggs now.
Oh dear.
I'm gonna need a lot.
Oh dear.
This guy, I think I'm gonna break out in a sweat. I gotta go.
Hey, you're gonna need a lot of birdseed there, Vern.
Yep. Okay. I gotta be glow in the dark eggs too.
Oh boy, glow in the dark. Yeah, that's gonna take a lot of work. So you better go get started on that.
No, I gotta go get started.
Okay. All right. Bye, Vern. Everybody, say bye, Vern.
My name is Vern.
Oh dear. Oh dear. Oh, kids, I am so sorry that y'all had to witness that. Pastor Ken, where are you? Has anybody seen Pastor Ken? Can anybody tell me where Pastor Ken is? Or else I might have to do this thing myself.
I'm here. Let the bells toll. I made it. Yes.
Finally.
I had, it's supposed to rain tonight. That's what kept me.
Yeah, you were late like a Kirk Cousins throw. Somebody threw too many interceptions last year.
Everybody knows about Aaron.
Well, yeah, the MVP.
Well, you know.
You know. Yeah. Anyway. Okay, anyway. I got to go. I need therapy after that session with Vern. That was dumb.
Oh, Vern. He helped you? I'm sorry.
Help is not a word I would use, but anyway.
All right. Well, thanks, Mr. Matt, for helping out to get started. I appreciate that. Wow. I tell you, we've got a really interesting character with us today again. His name is Dr. Love, and I'm going to have him come up and define what love is.
Oh, yeah. I'm here, Pastor Ken. I'm here. I see you out there. I love you. Love you.
Look at those glasses. It's no wonder you can see them.
I got to keep it real, you know.
I can see that.
When the world sees you a big star like I am, you're on fire. So you got to have fire glasses.
Fire glasses. There you go. All right. So, what is the definition of love today, Dr. Love?
I keep reading it over and over and over, because, you know, you always want to keep the Word of God in the forefront of your mind, right?
Forefront of your mind, that's
so
good.
I walk like this. I walk with it always, looking at it, thinking about it.
Do you ever bump into anything doing that?
Sometimes.
That would hurt, man.
Hey, but that's okay. I'm a doctor.
Yeah, see, that's one of the benefits of memorizing the Scripture. If you memorize the Bible, guess what, Doc?
What?
You don't bump into stuff, and you don't have to be reading while you're walking. See?
I can look at that. Hey, yeah. But, you know, don't cut into my money. I mean, I got to pay for this somehow. So.
Okay. Yeah,
anyway.
Okay.
So.
All right, go ahead. Okay. Give us the definition of love here from the one and only Dr. Love.
Yes, indeed.
Yes.
Love is patient.
Love is patient.
Love is kind.
Love is kind.
It does not envy.
Does not envy.
Not even just a little bit.
Not a little bit.
It does not boast.
Does not boast.
Not roast. Boast.
Not roast.
Yeah.
Boast.
Boast. It is.
Can
not
you roast a boast? That's a good
never
question.
Never tried.
I'll have to ask God when we get to heaven sometime. Can you roast a boast? Can you roast?
But
anyway, I'm sorry. Go
it's
ahead.
Also, it's not proud.
Not proud. Okay.
Meaning, you know, I guess I shouldn't be strutting up here thinking about all that with my
So then
family.
we should actually stay humble.
Yeah, I guess.
Yeah, and all our things. You kind of lost your glasses there.
Well,
earlier.
I'm going to take them off. I want to be kind of humble here. I don't want to be boasting and roasting and toasting.
Okay. All right.
It does not dishonor others.
It does not dishonor others?
Dishonor.
Oh, dishonor.
In other words, you don't put other people down.
Yeah, that's good. That's good. Dishonor. Yeah.
Now, I don't mean you can't tell people what's right, like put people in their place. When you know they're like talking trash, and you say, hey, whoa, now. But it just means you don't try to put people down and be mean and hateful, because it's all about the love, baby.
About the love. Yes, that's right.
Okay?
That's right.
It is not self-seeking.
Not self-seeking.
Does that mean
you're always looking for yourself? Is that what that means? Hey, where'd you go? I lost you in that hair.
Oh, right here. Yeah.
I thought I lost them.
I found myself.
Oh.
I had a religious experience. I found myself. Okay. It is not self-seeking, meaning I don't seek what works for me. I'm looking out for you.
So you're serving others, in other words.
I am.
Oh, that's cool.
Because that's what
cool.
Jesus would do.
Yeah.
And it's not easily angered.
not easily angered. In other words,
if I trip over a rock, I don't let that rock have it.
Do you go up and kick that rock? Show them who you are? Show them who's boss?
I could. I have every right to.
I hope you're wearing a steel-toed shoe.
I am.
Oh, that's good. That's good. Okay.
Okay, and it keeps no records of wrong, meaning...
If you
say something bad about me, I ain't going to remember it.
Well, that's good.
I'm going to try my best to forget and forgive and be like Jesus, because he don't want me to keep a big, long list of things that you did and pull it out like Santa and say, you know, well, you're blah, 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 and blah, 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 and blah, 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 you get nothing.
Do you want to know something, Dr. Love?
Sir.
We're using a different memory verse today.
We are?
Yeah, that was last week's.
Oh.
Yeah. So this week's, it's found, let's see, it says, here we go, you ready?
Sure.
It says, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul,
yeah,
and with all your brain, your mind. That's right.
Hey, I got a lot up in here.
Yeah. And then the other part of that is, and the second is like it. It says, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. That's right. You should love your neighbor as yourself. But, you know, I'm really glad that you brought up last week's because it's good to review it.
Hey,
it's always good to review it.
How you keep it in the forefront of your mind. Otherwise, you know, you're walking around and you look like an idiot.
There you go.
All righty.
See, you got to make sure to get the right directions on that phone of yours there.
No problem. Sir.
Okay, there you go. Nice. I like your new bracelet thing there going on.
Well, you know, you got to keep it real.
Gotta keep it real, dog. There you go. Dr. Love, thank you so much.
You're very welcome. I got a couple patients I got to work on, but I'll check back with you.
All right. He's going to be back probably next week. Hopefully with the right verse. Yes, but it was good because we needed the review. It's always good to review. Yeah, all right. Are you guys ready to do some praise and worship? All right, I need you guys to stand your feet and let's do it right now as we praise and worship the Lord. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Okay. Wow, isn't that great? I hope you like that song. It's always good to praise and worship the Lord. And I'm telling you, even after music is done, doesn't mean you have to stop. In fact, God loves the praises of his people, and you are one of his people. That's right. So you can continue to praise and worship him throughout your day. Isn't that awesome to know? Oh, I know all of you love to sing, right? Yeah. Well, that's good. And so right now, I'm going to have Mr. Matt come on down, and he's going to give us the Bible fun fact for today. So come on down, Mr. Matt. Here he comes once again.
I'm here again.
He's here.
Yeah, that took it out of me, all that with Vern earlier. threw my brain for a loop.
Yeah. Vern,
it threw me
that.
So much for a loop, I can't even do my need-to-know thing.
You don't need to know. Oh, by the way, what is our need-to-know?
Love God, love people.
Oh, that's easy simple. Enough. You guys know that one.
We do it every week.
So our need to know is, was it all again? Say it
love
again.
Love God.
Love people.
There we go. That's it.
Yeah.
That's all there is.
Well, that's good. That's good. That's kind of like going along with our memory verse this week about loving our neighbors as ourselves.
Yep.
That's cool. Where's that found? Like that. I bet you know where that's found.
Matthew 22, 37, and 39.
Oh, you forgot the good. Good. Oh, well.
I love getting him riled up.
He does that all the time.
Yeah, and he reacts every time, so it just gives me more incentive to do it.
All right, so give us the Bible fun fact.
Oh, the fun fact?
Yes, yeah. All right,
the Bible fun fact.
Here it is, the Bible fun fact that you need to know. This is really important stuff, so listen up. Go ahead.
Are you done so I can tell them now?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, cool.
I'm ready.
So the word love.
Yes.
Appears.
Is everybody listening? You're listening? Better be listening. Okay. All right. I'm just making sure.
The word love appears in the King James Bible 310 times.
I didn't catch any of that. My ears don't listen that fast.
Exactly. So you couldn't cut me off.
Oh, okay. Did I cut you off?
Yeah, a couple times.
Oh, I'm sorry. That's
all good. It's all good.
Okay. Go ahead and say it. I won't say a word. Not a word. I'm going to be quiet. Not saying anything. Shh.
The word love appears 310 times in the King James Bible. The word love.
Love.
Appears 310 times.
310 times?
In the King James Bible.
Well, that must make it pretty important if it's 310 times.
Well, one would think.
I would think so, yeah. Because, well, God is love.
Well, that would mean that.
So everything that comes from God is concerns love.
Which would include his whole word, which would be the Bible.
Yeah, absolutely. Man, that's really cool. 310 times.
That's a whole
now
lot.
You've got another fact.
You say, impress your parents with that one.
Oh, they'd be impressed.
Yeah, there you go.
I'd be impressed. Of course, if they're watching right now with you, you can't impress them because they already know it. So,
hey, don't give it away.
I know. I'm sorry. Shh. Don't tell your parents. Tell them later.
Yeah, you can tell your friends.
Yeah. That would be great. That'd be great.
And then they can tell other people.
There we go. And on and on and on. This is turning into another need to know.
Well, I mean, that's something important to know.
Yeah.
So.
All right. Well, thank you, Mr. Matt.
You're very
welcome.
That
fun fact. There he goes. Da, 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 da. Well, today we're talking about loving our neighbors ourselves. You know, there was a time in the Bible when there was these rulers and leaders of the time, and they were always trying to trick Jesus into saying the wrong thing, or they were always trying to give him questions that they thought, it's too hard for him. We're going to trick him, and then we can throw him in jail or do something like that to him. Well, there was one time he was in the temple. Well, you know, I don't want to give it away. So I'm going to have our wonderful friend Johnny Rogers come along, and he is going to help us to talk about loving our neighbor as ourselves. Let's take a look.
It's time for Nothing Actually Campy Theater.
Oh, yes. Well, hello, friends, and welcome back to the warmth of our rustic fireside. I am still not sure of what my name is, but here is my dear friend, Don. Say hello, Donnie. Well, what do we have here? It appears that we have a letter of love. Let's read what it says. Dear Sir Reginald Doofus, I know him. I think you look ridiculous, and I want to look just like you.
Oh.
What is that on your head? Is it a French poodle?
Bonjour.
or an English sheepdog?
Cheerio.
Which is better? Signed, Joshy Wooten from the Isle of Lucy. My favorite? It's difficult to say. You know, friends, we are all faced with difficult questions. In fact, you know, there's a story in the Bible where Jesus himself was faced with a difficult question. Why don't we take a look at that right now? Here we go.
Jesus was a great teacher. Folks would come from miles around to hear his thoughts and ideas. Many people loved Jesus and listened to everything he said.
What a great teacher, man! Jesus rocks!
Let's get the t-shirt.
But there were some who did not. They were the Pharisees, the Sadducees, and the teachers of the law.
Jesus? Oh, please us. Where's his fancy teaching stick and funny hat?
This guy's a teacher. He looks more like a kitchen cabinet maker. Come on.
Actually, he's a very excellent carpenter. He did my whole dining room in birchwood, or gopher wood. I needed work on the outside, but Jesus came and did the work on the inside, too. I'm a changed hand.
Even though they knuckled down every day to study the teachings of Moses, they had no love in their hearts. One day, Jesus was teaching in the temple. The Pharisees wanted to make him look silly. So they asked Jesus a very, 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 very difficult question.
And Jesus, out of all of the commandments of Moses, which is the most important?
Listen, everyone. The most important commandment has never changed.
Huh?
The Lord your God is one. Love the Lord your God with all of your heart, with all of your mind, and with all of your strength.
Ooh.
And love and care for other people in the same way you love and care for yourself.
Wow.
Big bada boom. He nailed it. Give him a hand.
Love God, love other people.
This guy really has a grasp on love, I'll tell you.
Hey, psst. Pull my finger.
Did you get it, dear ones? It was a two-part answer. Love God and love people. You see, what is most important involves love. No, not just for some, but for everyone. Well, that's all we have for you today for Not Exactly Campy Theater. So keep sowing the seeds of love, friends. Good day, all.
Wow, wasn't that an awesome story? I mean, here Jesus was in the temple, and the Pharisees, the teachers of that day, were trying to trick him. They were trying to set him up, get him trapped into saying something that they could accuse him of. Well, he saw what was coming. Oh, he's a son of God. And he saw it, he knew what was happening and stuff, and the Holy Spirit gave him the right thing to say at the right time. And they were like, they couldn't come back at it. You know, love God first and love your neighbor as yourself. And that's a very good thing to do. It's important to know that God wants us to love our neighbors as ourselves. We need to do that. We need to know that. We need to get that into our spirit. And when we do that, when we start loving our neighbors ourselves, that means we love everybody around us as God loves them. Now, I know there's some people that it might be really tough to love. You know, maybe the bully down the street or something like that. But you got to pray. This is where the Holy Spirit comes in. You pray and you ask the Holy Spirit, show me how I can be nice to that person today. How can I show a little bit of God's love to them? And maybe it's just a smile. Maybe it's just saying, have a good day. Yeah, there's lots of different ways. And I know that as you plant that seed, I mean, eventually the seeds will come up and it'll bring a good crop. It'll bring a good harvest in. And it'll change that person's heart. It's love that changes the heart. It's God's love that changed my heart. It'll change your heart. And all you have to do is ask him to come in. And so that's what we're going to do right now. We're going to give you an opportunity to experience God's love in a really personal way today. So I want everyone to bow your heads, fold your hands, close your eyes. Nobody looking around. That's right. And you too. Right there. Yeah. And so I want you to bow your heads. I want you to repeat this prayer after me. If you've never asked Jesus into your heart before, this is your opportunity to do that right now. So here we go. Dear Heavenly Father, I ask that you come into my heart. Forgive me of the wrong I've done. Help me to live for you. Help me to shed your love to everybody around me. Show me ways, creative ways, to show your love to those in my neighborhood, those in my school, those on my bus, wherever I might be. Lord, that I would continue and always continue to show your love to them. I thank you, Father God, that your love now is inside of me. So I love you and I thank you for being with me from this moment on. I give you all praise. In Jesus' name, and everybody said, amen. That's right, amen. Well, we've had another great time. That's right, we've had a great time. What was our need to know today again? What was it? Love God and what? Love people. That's right. We will see you next week. Get ready, be here or be square. All right, talk to you later. Bye-bye.